They play today at Bradford.
They're in 1996, but last year managed only 7 games as he battled the curse of the AFL footballer, injury. But away from the football field, Matthew Liptak spends his working days worrying about everyone else's injuries, as Dr. Liptak in the QEH's emergency ward. As Tricia Karp reports, combining a high-pressure and demanding job like medicine with a top-level football career is no mean feat.
And you've got what it takes for me.
Thursday morning at the Queen Elizabeth Hospital. Most footballers who pass through here travel on a stretcher, but not so Matthew Liptak, MBBS.
Alright, busy night?
Flat chat.
Flat chat.
This is where Matthew Liptak, the only playing medico in the AFL, spends his working days.
Just going to have a listen to your chest, all right? All right, we just bring
it's
that
the young doctor's
way.
Third year on the job, and like many other medicos, he's cutting his teeth in emergency.
Just breathe. Oh, it's great fun. It's good variety. Obviously, you can help a lot of people. And it's a good job.
The work's unpredictable, it's high pressure, and Matthew has to be ready to deal with all sorts of illnesses. These patients in the emergency ward need urgent care.
I'm just going to have a feel of his tummy now, just to see whether it's tender anywhere. I would like him to tell me if it's tender when I'm pushing down. All right.
It's a stark contrast to Matthew's other life, playing for the Crows.
Good play by Johnson, the Liptak.
I think it's a great balance. I like the challenge physically out on the footy field, and I like the challenge mentally when I'm the doctor.
But he's the first to admit things haven't been going so great.
Liptak, not all that accurate, the kicking made it though. It's a good effort by Matthew Liptak.
The 96 Crows club champion played only 7 matches last season. He's been nursing an Achilles injury ever since.
My aim for this year is to be sound for as long as I can and to see out the season and make sure I'm there for the last day rather than just play the first day and be injured and miss the rest of the season.
Back in emergency, things are starting to hot up. A new patient's been rushed in and Matthew is soon by her side.
And what happened last night? You became short of breath? What time did you become short of breath?
After
12 midnight.
It's a case of taking blood and finding out as quickly as possible exactly what's gone wrong.
At the moment, everything seems to be stable. I'm not saying it's good, but it's stable. All right.
Well, I want to say a few words. In this hospital, you know, when my wife, you know, got that hip operation, and we found 3 important things in this place. Kindness, understanding, and an excellent service indeed.
Thank you. I think I'm starting to like this job more and more because of that reason, that I can help people, and that sort of, at the end of the day, you know, makes everything worthwhile.
Right up in the air, Liptak. Oh, good mark. He's really the only one who went for it.
Despite Matthew's high profile as a footy player, here he's no different from anyone else, because there's just no time to talk footy or for accolades.
Hello there. You find it difficult to breathe, eh?
Yeah.
More difficult than before?
Yeah.
Let's get it moved out.
She done?
But he's decided to change focus this year. The days of working 70 hours a week are now long gone.
Medically, I'm working here 20 hours a week this year, just to allow me to keep on playing footy as long as I can. And then I'm going to pursue a specialist career in which area I'm not quite sure yet. One of the cardiology registrars is right here. By coincidence, so she wants to take you almost straight away and put you on a treadmill. Getting to this stage was quite difficult, and juggling was, you know, an important part of my day, really, between just ordinary social life or living life and working life and football life, and it was at times quite a full day, but very enjoyable.
But there's no denying that missing the Crows' winning grand final left Matthew with mixed emotions.
Some of the players were saying it was the greatest day of their life. I'm almost tempted to say it's one of the worst of mine.
So what are your goals now for your footy career?
To play in a winning grand final. Personally, if and play as long as possible.
Great effort. We'll be back.